And start off here with an 1889 Indian head cent. Some of these coins have sold in 2021. The other coins did sell in 2020 in December. So this coin here is a Indian head 1 cent coin that was struck 20% off center. Pretty rare for a coin like this to be struck off center. And it's in pretty good condition. Graded at a Mint State 65 Brown by the coin grading company PCGS. This coin ended up selling for over $1,600. So wow, $1,600. Now here is a super, super rare coin. This is a 1913, was supposed to be a 1913 Buffalo Nickel. This was actually struck onto a $5 planchet. So an Indian half eagle, that is just awesome. So something like this, of course, is going to be super, super unique, like one of a kind type of thing. And that's why this nickel sold for over $78,000. That's right, $78,000. So keep in mind, just because you have a 1913 nickel and it could be in bad shape, it doesn't mean that it's valuable. There's different things that can give these coins some value, so make sure you watch my 1913 Buffalo Nickel video. Now here's another Buffalo Nickel from 1925, graded at a Mint State 64, so in very good condition, and this coin was struck 20% off center. So off centers can happen on all kinds of coins, as we'll see here as we move on in the video today. This coin ended up selling for over $1,300. So again, over $1,000 coin. Now here is another off-center. However, this is taking place on the 1943 Walking Liberty half dollar coin. The coin has been cleaned, unfortunately, so definitely do not clean your coins, especially something like this, because this is gonna be super valuable. This coin sold for over $8,000. So had it not been cleaned, it could have sold for even more money. This is one of my favorite coin designs ever. For this to be struck this off center, super rare. Now here is a 1964 Lincoln cent. As you can see here, the coin has been triple struck three different times and off center. That is amazing. Something like this, super, super unique and rare. That's why this coin sold for over $660. Now here is a 1965 Washington quarter that was struck 35% off center. It's graded by PCGS at a Mint State 62, and this quarter ended up selling for over $100. So, you know, are you gonna make a huge profit off something like this after you get it graded? No, you're really not, because you're gonna have to pay to get it graded and shipping and all that stuff. If you guys wanna know more about coin grading, I have a whole 30-minute video on that. Just type in coin grading couch collectibles, watch that 30-minute video. We actually go to the coin grading websites and show you guys your different options. Now, here is a 1968 S Mintmark Jefferson nickel that was struck onto a 1 cent planchet. Now this coin ended up selling for over $400 because of that mint error. So always inspect your coins closely, weigh them. That way you guys don't pass up on a good coin like this. Now here is a 1969 D mint mark. It looks pretty normal here on the reverse of this Roosevelt dime. And here on the obverse, we can see that it has a different color. It's got that inner copper layer of the coin being exposed because the outer clad layer is missing. So we see the clad layer on the reverse, but not on the obverse of the coin. So that will give it a little bit of value. This coin ended up selling for over $130. Of course, the condition or the grade of the coin always affects the coin's values as well. So keep that in mind when the coin sells as well, and kind of the demand, you know, at the time for something like this. So here is a very cool coin. This is the Bicentennial Washington Quarter 1976. That was actually the proof quarter. So this isn't the business strike. It is graded by NGC at a proof 67. So this Washington quarter was overstruck onto a 1967 Roosevelt dime, which is really, really cool. You can actually see the design of the dime as well as the quarter, and this coin ended up selling for over $15,000. That's right, $15,000. Now this next coin here, you can look for these on all kinds of different coins. We refer to them as CUDs. They are die breaks. You can see the CUD covering up the date. That's why it's listed as a, or graded at a no date, because the CUD is covering up the date. So you can look for those. Some of them will be much larger than this and take up a large portion of the coin. Some will even be much smaller. This coin ended up selling for over $150. All right, guys, don't forget to subscribe in the middle. Check out the videos to the left of me. And until tomorrow, I'll see you guys in the comment section below. This is Couch Collectibles, and this is where I disappear.